Welcome to Anime Thoughts, where I, your anime thought, will lead you into discussion. Today's topic is the top 10 worst anime on Hulu. Like all the other Hulu videos, I use realgood.com to help find all the anime on Hulu, being that I'm not the smartest when trying to find all of the anime on that site. I have created a Discord channel, yay! And it's not completely done, but for all the weebs out there, the link will be in the description below. Last thing before we get started, you may have noticed I haven't uploaded lately, and if you're curious, I will tell you all about it at the end of the video. Let's get started. Number 10, Basilisk is currently the worst rated in Real Good, coming at a 4.5 out of 10, which if you don't know is really, really bad. This explains why I have never been able to finish the series as soon as I started up. I have always felt guilty for it, but now I feel a bit more relieved. It's somewhat of a Romeo Juliet with ninjas, and it seems awesome, but you never quite can finish it. Or maybe you can. Maybe you're not like me. Number 9. Chaos Dragon Sekiryu Seneki. First of all, the animation doesn't seem that bad, and the plot seems really good, so why is it subpar, you may be thinking. The answer lies in the comments on my anime list. Apparently, the CGI in this anime was done poorly. When CGI is already hard to manage, you have to be very cautious, and by the comments, it was done badly. Basically, two countries are fighting, and you see the after effects of the war, and there's a dragon. Number 8, After Lost. I really had hoped it would have done better, being that I like the art style and the plot. Apparently, it was designed after a mobile game, which typically spells disaster, being that the strong point of the company is to make mobile games and not anime. It shows exactly why it might be a bad idea. It just didn't have a very good developing plot as I had hoped, and also the rotating camera is probably what put the icing on the cake. Basically, a city went missing called Lost, and the two people go on a journey looking for it. Number 7, The Quasar of Stigmata. In 2010 is when it came out, and that's about the time when tons of ecchi anime started to enter this anime community. I truly believe this anime was just to ride that bandwagon to riches, but the anime shows how that plan can fail miserably. So if you want to see an average ecchi anime, boy is this one for you. It's not terrible, but it's just not good, and the ratings will show you that on any website you go to. Number 6, Dias Irae. I watched this one fully through, and halfway into the series, I couldn't help but wonder, what is going on, why is this happening, and why am I still watching it? The plot seems so interesting, being that the last Nazis were going around trying to take over cities. They are super powerful, and it's a secret organization, but it was just poorly done in every aspect. I really wanted this anime to capture my attention, but I was just lost the entire time. Number 5, Girls Beyond the Wasteland. The MC has a talent for writing scripts, which, let's be honest, I wish I had. But anyway, he gets recruited in a club to develop games. I haven't seen this anime, but I can only guess how boring it could be with a rating of 5.8. Apparently, it's a Sakano anime, or that's what people thought it was, and that's the major reason why it got a bad rap. So this might not be that bad of an anime. Number 4, Blade and Soul. If you have seen some of my other videos, you might know how I feel about this anime. I won't deny that it's pretty bad, the pacing seems off, and the direction of the anime is questionable. But if you have ever played Blade and Soul, you might find this anime somewhat enjoyable, as I did. It's on this list because ratings don't lie, but I kinda secretly liked it. Number 3, Dance with Devils. In this game, there are devils and vampires, where the MC gets pulled into the darker side of the world after her mother is kidnapped. She needs to be able to get her mother back, and it seems the only way is by talking with the high school council that seems to be dabbling in the devils and vampire part of the world. The plot sounds good, but apparently the ecchi part of this anime is extremely cringy with loads of panty shots and the like. This seems like an anime that's a hit or miss for sure. Number 2, Soul Eater Not. Although the anime is clearly telling you it's not Soul Eater, you can't help but expect something similar to Soul Eater, because why would you make the reference in the first place? It has nothing to do with Soul Eater, and it probably would have done much better if they wouldn't have used that in the title. The anime is just there with no real plot or anything for that. It just doesn't say anything you want in anime. I know all of these seem like critiques, but hey, they are the lowest rated for a reason. Number 1, Amnesia. The main character loses her memories where she finds out that she is the only one that can see Orion. He is partly to blame for her memory loss, so he vows to help her find them. She doesn't want to affect everyone in her life, so she tries to hide the fact with the ones in her life. It's a reverse harem where the boys for no reason love her to death. The pacing is also too slow for any type of anime, and that is probably a big factor in its rating. I will say the art style is somewhat interesting. Hey guys, don't forget to subscribe if you like the video. I just want to thank everyone for subscribing lately. It really does feel amazing, and we are growing at a very fast rate. This is one of the only things I ever wanted to do in life, and I wouldn't be able to do it without all of your support. With that being said, I am very sorry for not uploading lately. I have been sick with what I thought was a cold, but it's a bit more serious. I just got out of the hospital, and I've just been a little preoccupied. It's not anything life-threatening, but I thought y'all deserved to know why I've been so infrequent. I'm getting back into the groove, and I hope you guys enjoy the content coming. Last major news is that our channel got monetized, which means we made it, boys. Not really, being that we are a small channel, but it means I can turn my hobby into my life's work without having to worry about feeding myself. Again, this is all amazing news, and I couldn't thank all of you enough. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you weebs in the next one.